Hey, what's up, everyone? Here we are, segment two, Back in Blue, episode 66. Thank you very much for joining us. I don't know if I even introduced us on the first segment, but it doesn't matter.
They know who we are by now.
You better. I would hope so. If they're watching, why not?
This is Kevin. That's Bill.
Yeah.
I'm Ricky.
Yeah. No doubt. Ricky over there. I love it. Now, this is going to be a bit of a serious segment to start, at least, because Melky Cabrera had some serious news this week and is, I guess, is some good news in a sense. It was revealed that he apparently has been hiding back pain for about 4 months. I don't know, did the trainers know about it and didn't report it, or did he just, was he hiding it? Did you hear about that exactly?
The report was that he was hiding it to an extent. I mean, really, yeah. We all saw him run. That's not they much doing for the hiding it. But also, he's playing with, like I said, for a lot of pride, and he's going to want to go out there. And they said that he's the type of competitor where you're going to have to drag him to the trainer's room
to
get checked out.
Yeah, so apparently he didn't get his back checked over. All these MRIs and different things on his legs never revealed that he actually had a tumor growing on his spine, which is very scary, very serious. But luckily it was a benign tumor, and they got rid of it. They had surgery. He went under the knife and expected to be a full recovery. So obviously that's great. That's good to see, or good to hear. But what are your thoughts on, you know, is this probably the reason, or do you think this could be factor large reasons why he was so slow and things like that? Like, from what I heard, AA, I'm sure you guys heard his interview also, he was saying that, you know, the spine obviously affects the strength in the lower body, and it definitely has an effect on it. You know, is that what we've seen all year from Melky, do you think?
I'm really not too sure. I mean,
I guess we're guessing. We're not doctors.
Yeah, it's total guess. I've never dealt with any kind of severe back pain, or never really seen it first or second hand, so I don't know, but I remember talking to you guys last week after the podcast about his knees and reminding me of myself and how his knees are kind of slowing down a little early on him, and it didn't look good. I thought everything was pointing to that he had some bad knees that were really slowing him down, but now with this whole back and malignant tumor or benign tumor and this is just like, everyone's pointing to how positive this is that they got rid of it. Maybe it's going to lead to some better performance. But as far as it affecting his legs, I don't know. I don't know.
Honestly, I think you just hit a good point. We're going to move on. But I think the fact that whether it affects his performance or not, whether his performance is better, it doesn't really matter because he's healthy. That's all that matters, really.
Yeah, it's positive.
Let's look at the fact, right?
It's positive.
That's the truth. So how about we talk about Jose Bautista? Mm-hmm. You know, things are, well, he's out for the year also, but, you know, they're looking better, I guess, long term. Do you think Jose is going to come back and be the same player that he has been? I mean, it's starting to scare me, being a Jose Bautista fan.
Go ahead, Drew.
You want me to take this one? As far as Bautista goes, I mean, this is the guy who he's going to give you 110% every time he goes out in the field. I don't think he's ever mailed it in any game that we've seen him play. Maybe sometimes his emotions get the better of him, but I don't think physically he's going to go out there and not try to make a play. With that being said, he's a guy who's going to sacrifice his body more often than not in order to make things happen for his ball club. And with the risk of further injuring his hip the way it is right now, there's really no sense in it. Or is it his hip?
No, it's not his hip. That's what it was at first. It was his femur. They're saying it was his femur.
Oh, apparently, it switched from that.
Yeah, apparently at the, I think they described it as the neck of the femur, which is probably the
Yeah, higher.
I thought that'd be lower, but it seems if they're saying hip before, it'd be the higher part.
Well, let's just say he's hurt. Okay, we don't want him to hurt anymore.
Yeah, no, it's true though. But it's another September. It's another September. Jose is not playing, and that's another thing that frustrates me because I mean he's not going to be here too much longer if this is happening.
From what I've heard with the injury, I've heard deep bone bruise.
Yeah,
the hip area. I'm calling BS on that injury. To put him out for the season.
Well, they're saying
they're giving him a rest.
Yeah, they said like, technically it'd be 2 weeks, and then when you recover and rehab, he'd come back and there'd be four games left, apparently. That's a
lot. So it's like, might as well. I mean, he could still be playing. They're giving him a rest because this season's a wash, and there's no point in risking any further injury, which, as far as I'm concerned, wouldn't really happen.
No, I mean, injuries are usually flukes, or, you know.
If it's a bruise, it's a bruise. A deep bone bruise is a deep, it's essentially exactly what it is. Yeah. They'll heal. Even if you re-aggravate them, they'll just heal.
Now, how
he's
about
got
the fact
all
that
summer to heal.
He I mean, winter. Winter. Yeah, how about the fact that they pretty much guarantee he'll be back and ready for spring training? I mean, does that just show that he should be, or he could be playing now, or is that
absolutely,
just,
if you ask me. He's
is that
fine.
Just ill-advised? You think he's fine?
He's totally fine, yeah. They're just being precautionary on, as far as I'm concerned.
Yeah, I'm hoping that also. Yeah.
I think the bigger question is his numbers downfall, which is not ridiculously significant, but is his clear downfall going to continue?
Yeah, the last
which
couple
I
years.
Think you touched on that.
He's regressing. It's true. I mean, yeah. His numbers aren't there. He's not hitting. He's not 300 hitter.
No.
He's not a 40 home run hitter.
Yep. Well, let's be honest. He's never really been that 300 hitter. I mean, we had that one incredible season in 2011 where it was like watching a guy who was playing out of his league, and it was incredible. And I think a lot of people took that for granted.
It's true.
Basically, the fact about Bautista is that he's a 260 hitter. He's going to get on base, and he's going to hit you about 30 home runs. And what did he do this season? Pretty much there.
And he's missed a lot of action.
He's missed a lot of games. So I don't think there's a real question about his value, his stability. Let's say maybe as an outfielder, who knows how much the turf plays into this? Yeah. Who knows about injuries? We all know turf's hard to play on. I mean, I remember when we were in Toronto this winter, and we were talking to guys like Lloyd Mosby.
Coaches camp,
And Lloyd Mosby was saying there's some sort of big legal pursuit on about the Blue Jays for all the players that have bad hits playing on AstroTurf.
Yeah.
You know, this is the type of thing that happens.
But
and,
when you interviewed Kelly Gruber, he went on about the turf for
a long time.
Yeah,
Bone Spurs. Yep. You know what I'm saying? It's a tough way to play baseball, and that's why you only see a couple of stadiums that employ the turf anymore.
Yeah, and I seen someone or some sort of someone brought up the fact that or the thought that they should ban turf. I can't remember who said that right now, but I think it's true. I mean,
everybody in the 90s.
Yeah, I know it's in the 70s. I know it's all Blue Jay fans as well, but someone actually that has some clout in baseball sense.
Yeah.
And I can't remember right now, but
I wonder what the doctors and rehab guys and all those science guys
sure they recommend
science
it.
Of it. Yeah. And somebody posted on Twitter recently an advertisement for turf, like "Welcome to the Future, Turf," and it was like from 1970 newspaper clip. It was really interesting.
Oh yeah, probably when the Astrodome was
Something like there, that. Yeah, it was really interesting to see, but the turf can be a bit of a killer, man.
For sure. All right, stay tuned, come back for segment 3 and we'll wrap it up.